doors creak and the tombstones quake.
Roofs and mockers wane and wake.
Happy haunts materialize
and begin to vocalize.
Grim, grim ghosts about to socialize. Now don't close your eyes and don't try to hide.
Or a silly spook.
All right.
All right. And off they go.
Oh.
Team Sire coming in. Does manage to land.
And so again, red team seems to be the aggressors here, moving on to the blues. The blue team ship. We're just seeing people getting dunked everywhere here. Strong's right back over to his side.
That's actually happening, though. Popsy alone on with all of the other enemy team members. Become Bloling and Donkey Tech just trading, but like no actual deaths. Creo's dodging so many balls there on the end.
Interestingly, each team has returned to their own ships and seem to just be shooting over to the other one. That's the first time we've actually seen that. Most teams choosing to be aggressive and just push into the other ship, but now we're seeing a battle over the bridges.
Yeah, I think they're just going for a health game now. I mean, frankly, it is pretty much impossible to just walk over the bridge. You have to basically shoot yourself over.
Yeah.
You will just get shot off.
I'm seeing some people twitching by the bridges with their bottles out. Fuck it, we ball seeming to take an aggressive step. Oh, and we've got
maybe they're balling.
In.
Oh yeah, red team has just said fuck it. Forward. They exchanged IBG dying and Strong dying.
Fuck it, we ball jumping right back over. Now, we've traded ships now, I think.
Yeah, I believe they're on each other's ships.
Going back to the long game again. Young Messiah trying to push Popsy off the edge. He gets it!
Works!
Oh, what a great play! Popsy falling in, trying to go for the
ball going down too, though. 3v3.
3v3, still evenly matched. Kreos charging over.
Very ballsy play from Kreos.
Oh my god! Kreos!
Yeah, Young
right
Messiah
over.
Punishing that, it hard.
That crit Oolipal cable is lethal. Jesus. So we're down to a 2v3 right now. Still very doable for the red team here. 2v3
Absolutely.
Is not too much of a disadvantage. They do choose to split up, though. I'm not sure if that'll be the best play for them. Well, they have come back together now. Again, we're seeing the long game again.
I think at this point, honestly, the long game is going to not go in the favor of Donkey Tech.
They jumped in.
Yeah, both of them going in here. They're at a health disadvantage. They kind of have to go for it.
They are. We've got some blue players on low health as well, but...
Yeah, Peemsai is incredibly low. He will die to a fart in the wind.
Peemsai
his off ticket got cancelled, and he is no longer in the game.
Oh, that's very unfortunate.
So, unfortunately, because Busy
that's
left.
That's really unfortunate for them. He was on very low health.
Well, Peemsai was going to go anyway, so I doubt it would have changed much, but still, not ideal.
Not ideal.
With that, the first one is going to go to become Bloling.
All right, and we're straight in. Be interesting to see which team takes
team
the aggressive
Team Psy is back.
Red team, that would be.
IVG going
in. IVG, no one's seen him, seemingly.
No one saw
he
him.
One.
Oh, but he didn't fly off.
Oh, no, IVG, that is dirty.
No worse feeling than getting the caber hit, but not getting
the
kill.
Oh, no! Strunks just accidentally falls in. He went to jump over to his side and missed, by the looks of it.
Kreos playing it risky. And again, a reminder here, if Become Bloling wins this, Donkey Tech will get eliminated, and what I would definitely say is an upset.
Oh, no. Popsy just got sent straight off the edge. We're down to a 3v4 again.
Another trade, but they have a one-player add in favor of Donkey Tech.
Seems like going for the Oolipal kill. Doesn't get it.
It would seem they've traded ships.
They've traded ships once again. We were seeing some more aggressive plays, but now they've returned to the long game once more, shooting across at each other.
Yeah, I don't think they were particularly, like, you know, they gotta try it out like a new car, you know, see which one they like better.
Interesting seeing both teams seemingly mutually agreeing that the long game is the way to play it.
Peemsai saying, fuck it, we ball. Fortunately not getting any value.
It seems we may be having another ship trade, potentially. But they do seem to be trying to keep them on. Red aggressively going towards Fuck Me Bill.
Yeah, It would definitely seem that Become Bloling is just immediately going to the other ship every time they try to go.
He else gets.
Oh!
Oh! Is he coming in?
Oh! He is knockbackable in this cannon!
Incredible. We're back 3v4 still. Both teams at similar health advantages. There, no one's really at any of an advantage, actually. Except for the player. Someone gets
knocked up. And they've exchanged ships again by the look of things.
IVG got knocked up and didn't manage to regain his footing, gets knocked straight into the water. They're now on a 3v3. This is very close. These are the closest games we've seen, really. Most games...
Definitely the most drawn-out one. Yeah. They refuse to do the up-close, dirty engagements.
Yeah, these teams want to win.
honestly, it's working out and Become Bloling's favor. They've just been whittling away here at the...
Teams are jumping in again.
Yeah. And look, immediately Become Bloling just heads back to the other side.
It's an interesting defensive playstyle. I mean, it'd be interesting to see if it actually does pay off for them.
It seems to be, considering they have to expend health. Yep, Beamsai gone down. Off.
Beamsai has definitely been the most aggressive player so far.
If
definitely
I were them, I would switch. I would switch to a more aggressive playstyle now if I was Become Bloling. I mean, they do have Ad.
Krios and Master and... both pretty low.
Yeah. I think Dizzy is out of ammo, just going for melee hits.
Again, it's going to be very close by the looks of it. It is a 3v2, but again, as we've seen, that doesn't necessarily mean the end. They're still playing quite the defensive game. Continuing to choose to run over to the other team.
Again. Fuck it, we ball kind of isolated, though.
Oh!
Yeah, and that isolation right bites him in the ass.
So we get 2v2. It'll be interesting to see. Red team definitely taking the dominant position here.
They are lower health, so...
Oh, that's unfortunate.
On a 2v1. This would be unprecedented, Donkeytech.
Oh, he gets it!
And Donkeytech is out!
Incredible.
2-0. What a fucking upset. Holy crap.
I mean, that is not what I was expecting.
That is not what I expected at all. And like we said, underdog. The underdog takes it.
We love to see an underdog here. So that is going to put... let me have a look really quickly. That'll put us with Become Bloling against TF in the semifinals.
Yeah, so that was exactly the upset that I was hoping we would see.
Absolutely. I'm going to be very interested to see this game between TF and Bloling, because Bloling playing incredibly defensive and TF playing incredibly aggressive. Yeah. I'm going to be very interested to see.
I have to wonder if any of the other teams are going to take notes from that game to maybe adopt that more defensive playstyle in the upcoming matches here.
Yeah. What we've seen with the aggression so far is losing the first team to lose a player always gets that initial disadvantage. But going in aggressive doesn't necessarily mean that you'll get that, because we've seen from that previous game, people that have jumped in and get knocked straight off, and that defensive playstyle right at the beginning might actually work out for some teams. I think it really depends on your players and what.
Yeah, absolutely.
As the moon climbs high over the dead oak tree,
spooks are ripe for the midnight tree.
Creepy creeps with eerie eyes
start to shriek and harmonize when we both start to socialize.
When you hear the knell of a requiem bell,
we're closing where spirits dwell.